Dear friends of a sharp edge, today we are taking a closer look at this little beauty by Gerber. It's called a sheepfoot blade because of the blade shape. What can it do? Is it any good? More in this video. The Gerber Quadrant belongs to the rare species of sheepfoot knives. Now, technically speaking, it's a liner lock knife with a pin that allows for one-hand operation. Gerber says on their website it is easily deployed, but one cannot expect high-quality ball bearings at this price point. Yet still, with the bamboo inlay and all, in my personal opinion, this is more a style knife than a practical tool. Reminds us a little bit of the traditional barber knives, and actually I really like sheepfoot knives, so let us take a closer look at this one. But before we do that, let me tell you why this kind of blade is actually called a sheepfoot blade. Of course, that is because the shape resembles the form of a sheep's hoof. Or is it because traditionally the handle was made using sheep bones? It is called a sheepfoot knife because traditionally this shape of blade was used to cut the hooves of sheep and horses, because thanks to the tip, or to this kind of tip, or rather to the missing tip, you cannot accidentally hurt your patient.
Oh yeah!
The quadrant is where form and function intersect.
Come on, intersect, I said, intersect. Doesn't intersect every time though. So that's our sheepfoot in all its glory. And as you can see here, the overall length is 17.5 centimeters. And that is about 9.5 or 10 centimeters for the handle, which leaves us about 6.5 centimeters effective cutting edge, effective blade length. So as you can see here, it's a frame lock, closing nicely. There is no motion in a wrong direction involved. The blade sits quite sturdily on the axis. Frame lock locks it nice and tight. But as you can see here, right after the choil, there's some excess metal, which makes it quite impossible to put the knife flat on a grinding stone. That is also quite some non-symmetrical factory cut. So I decided to do something about that. More on that in a couple of seconds. All the screws are torque type. Here's a closer look at the frame lock. Again, locking the blade tightly in place. You can see here on the edges the black coating has already vanished. That is one of the reasons why I'm not a big fan of such black coatings in spots like these, because after a couple of days, physics takes its toll. Here is our bamboo inlay with the Gerber logo, torque screws, thumb stud, and the blade. Some medium to low grade steel, so I decided to remove the excess metal, which I mentioned before, using my Dremel or my firm and a diamond grinder. Not a very great idea on an expensive knife or on a harder type of steel, but here with this Gerber, it worked out quite nicely. I actually increased the size of the choil, losing maybe 1 or 2 millimeters of cutting edge, which wasn't cutting edge anyway because of the excess metal. And then after a little polishing, looks like this. I know that is a pretty rough job, but it allowed me to really sharpen the knife on my whetstone. Because out of the box, knife is sharp, it does cut paper, but it's far from razor sharp. And I wanted to see how sharp I could get it.
Oh yeah!
Weather is great here at the Emperor's Water, or Kaiserwasser in German. And I don't know if you can see it right behind me, there's some guys playing ice hockey at the frozen part of the lake. Most of it is just frozen a little bit, This is the shadowy corner. And I came here today to talk a little bit about my Sheepfoot knife. You know, Pula and Capri came with us as well. And they are having fun because it's sunny and the weather is getting warm. So what about the usefulness of the Sheepfoot knife of Gerber's little retrofit? Well, I gotta say, it doesn't really flip well. It's small, it's nice, but this is a knife which you want to have for decorative reasons. I don't know about you, I rarely ever shave off the hooves of my calves, cows or sheep for that matters. But still, the form of this particular blade allows for very precise cutting. There's a good reason why razor blades often look like this, the old-fashioned razor blades that hairdressers used to use, that are used in barber shops. Nowadays, especially in times of Corona, it's all about one-time usage blades, so they mostly exchange the blade for a scalpel blade, but this is like an old-school razor. The effective part of the blade is not that long. So the question is, will it cut an apple? From a practical viewpoint, it's not a great knife, but as with so many things knife related, it's often more a question of style than features. And let's face it, this is a very good knife for any retro weekend party. I like the design, you can't have it all. Precise cutting, pretty sharp, retains an edge. But hey, it's not a perfect kitchen tool. For shaving, maybe. These are really good apples. Swansies, or devil birds, as we like to call them in Austria.